Hi everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today I'm going to show you how to measure the density of small, irregularly shaped objects. But first, let's measure the density of this rock by using a method that you probably learned in your 8th grade science class. We're first going to zero the scale, and then I'm going to weigh the rock and write down its weight. Of course, the scale is actually converting the weight or force that the rock is applying on it into mass by multiplying it by gravity. Grams is not a unit of weight. Now to get its volume, we're going to take a graduated cylinder, or in this case a beaker, fill it up to a known level with water, put the rock in. The rock is going to displace the water up to an amount which you can then read off is 70 milliliters. So it started at 60, now at 70. That means that the rock's volume is roughly 10 milliliters. Now if I divide its mass by its volume, I get 2.8 grams per cubic centimeter, a value which is pretty common for ordinary crustal rocks. Now what would happen if instead of a large rock, you had to measure the density of a tiny crystal? You see, for something this small, you'd have to use a graduated cylinder with markings on the order of a hundredth of a milliliter. I know the university does, but I don't personally own a graduated cylinder that's that accurate. However, I do have a scale that can measure out to the milligram. Since the scale is far more accurate than my beaker, how about I devise a method to measure the density of something where the scale is actually the limiting factor for the precision that I can get. So I have a beaker of water sitting on the scale. If we zero the scale out, and then I take my finger and stick it into the water, watch what happens. Even though I'm supporting the weight of my finger, the scale still reads an amount of weight. This is because you'll notice that the water level goes up and down. By sticking my finger in there, it's as if I added extra water. The water is trying to push up on my finger, and so I have to push down with a little bit of force, and that force is transferred to the scale. Now, if I suspend a piece of wire down into the water, you can see that the wire displaces some of the water, and I'm reading a weight on the scale because, again, it's pushed up on the water, and so it's as if I added more water to it. Now, the iron weighs more than water, but any extra weight is being supported by the frame of the scale and is not being measured. So the only thing that I'm measuring here is the buoyant force, which is pushing up on the wire. Now, if I zero this out, I can now add something to the wire and measure the amount of buoyant force on the object. Now, since I'm using water, the number of grams should correlate to the number of cubic centimeters that this object displaces. Let's actually drop the object into the water. This actually gives me its mass because now the object combined with the beaker is being listed here. So that is 0.333 grams, a third of a gram. But now if I support some of the object's weight by suspending it on the wire, I should have just the buoyant force right here, which tells me that the object is right about 0.1 milliliters in volume. Doing the math, you can see that the density of this crystal is 3.505 grams per centimeter cubed. That value is exactly what I'd expect because this crystal is actually clear topaz. Now, I know this piece is actually brass, but it is yellow and it's sort of heavy, so it looks a lot like gold. Let's see if I can use this method to tell them apart. Here's the mass of the brass nugget, and right there is the mass of the gold. There's how much the brass displaces, and there's the gold. Right there, 0.117. The beauty about using this method is it doesn't actually matter if there's bubbles on the side of the glass, or if there's a little bit of water up top, or even if there's a little bit of water on the plate. As long as the amount of water doesn't actually change, then it's all valid. So doing the math on these numbers, I come up with 19.33 for the gold and 8.23 for the brass. The brass is less than half as much as the gold is. Now, to measure the density of the tiny piece of platinum that I got from the spark plugs is going to be a bit more tricky because its volume is going to be on the order of 2 microliters, which is incredibly small. In fact, I wouldn't really trust this scale to measure it because this scale is only good for plus or minus 2 milligrams. You see, it randomly changes from time to time. I mean, it's still pretty good to get the weight of the pellet, which is right about 40 milligrams. But the thing is, the amount of water that it's going to displace is going to be down into the 2 milligram range, which this scale really can't measure. So I'm going to have to use a denser liquid to displace. So here it is, the densest room temperature liquid known to man, mercury. Well, I suppose mercury with gold dissolved into it would be slightly heavier. So now that I've got the straw positioned inside the mercury, I'm gonna tear that weight. Now, I'm going to drop the platinum, and I'm gonna pick it back up. I'm gonna bring it over here and stick it onto the little pad that I put it. Did I catch it? I think we got it. Okay, so now the mercury is being displaced by the platinum. Let's bring this back over here so you can see the weight. And there we go. 0.026 grams of mercury displaced by the platinum. So here is the mass of mercury displaced. Divide that by the density of mercury and we get the number of milliliters that was displaced by the tiny platinum ball. Dividing that by its mass of 40 milligrams, we have 20.822 grams per cubic centimeter, which is pretty close to the actual value of platinum. It's not surprising that I didn't get it exactly because it's just such a tiny object. If the bead was a perfect sphere, it'd be as simple as taking the diameter of it and plugging it into this equation. Unfortunately, the bead is sort of shaped like this. See, it's not a perfect sphere, it's slightly flattened at the bottom. So what I need to do is take the measurement here and here and then average the two so that I can get something which is more of a sphere. All right, let's take the small diameter, 1.42, and the large diameter looks like 1.50. Averaging those two numbers, we get 1.46. Plugging that into our equation, and we get 1.629 cubic millimeters. Dividing the 40 milligrams by 1.63 cubic millimeters gives us 24.5 grams per cubic centimeter. So there you go. I could probably do better if I took more measurements around the bead, and it is pretty close to the value of platinum. And in fact, I think the measurements that I took using the scale and the mercury displacement were actually better. So how about that? Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time.